Destructive relationship games are communication or behavioral patterns that interfere with honest and vulnerable communication. If you're talking but you don't really feel like you know what your partner is thinking or feeling, a relationship game is probably afoot. Relationship games flourish when one of you acts like a victim. These games ensure that either one person wins or no one wins. Either way, the relationship certainly loses. The solution to all relationship games is honest communication, so let's get right to it. Relationship communication is about being honest with each other. It's also about the intimacy of revealing yourself to each other. When you share honestly and deeply, you will achieve true intimacy and trust. But we're humans, not saints, so sometimes things get in the way, even though we don't want them to. Here are two relationship games that block intimacy and distract you from the truth of your relationship. The first one is the blame game. We all make mistakes. It's tough to accept personal responsibility for your mistakes because they cause feelings ranging from shame to anger to powerlessness. And your ego usually works overtime to stop you from feeling any of those. A quick way to recognize the blame game is when an excuse begins with, "if it weren't for you." For example, "if it weren't for you, I'd have a fulfilling job. It's your fault that I don't have a degree. I can't pursue my passion because of you." There are times when someone or something else is indeed to blame, but we're not talking about institutionalized racism or misogyny for now. Blaming your partner for your circumstances puts you in a place of powerlessness. Taking responsibility means you have agency to change your situation. Once you realize you're playing the blame game, apologize to your partner and be gentle with your ego. It's only trying to keep you safe. Ask yourself, what's really holding you back? Are you maybe afraid of failing deep down? Or are you afraid of what you would have to give up to really go after what you want? Whatever it is, it's not too late to start over now. Know that you can set a new goal and begin again anytime. If your partner is playing the blame game, you'll have to be extra understanding. You have to separate their attack from how it makes you feel and see it for what it probably is, their ego trying to protect them from feeling shame or embarrassment. I know that's hard, and you might even be in an attack-defense loop and have been for years, so these won't change until one of you changes their response. What if you didn't take their blame personally next time, but instead ask them how else they're feeling and take it from there? So we all make mistakes, and we all try to protect our egos by blaming other people. Luckily, a mistake is something you can learn from and have the power to rectify by doing things differently in the future. An experience like that is only wasted if you don't learn anything from it. The next relationship game is the yes but game. The rules for this game are basically, I'm going to show you that I'm right and there is no solution. There are three actors in this game: a problem needing to be solved, a person asking for help who doesn't really want help, and a person or group who wants to help. We've all played this game before. If you were the one helping or trying to give a solution, you know how frustrating it can be. If you were the one seeking a solution, it's time to realize that you don't need to fake your needs and you don't need to be a victim. What do I mean by faking your needs? This game is usually begun by someone who wants attention, not help. They have an unconscious desire to show what a hopeless place they're in so people take pity and take care of them. But they also want to prove that the experts or friends are wrong and that their situation is uniquely terrible and unsolvable. The problem with that is the way our minds work. If you don't want to solve your problem, your subconscious will support you by helping you come up with excuses. You will also do things to sabotage yourself and your relationship just so that there's no cognitive dissonance in your mind. You're creating your own self-fulfilling prophecies. So how do you stop this game? The key to ending this game is in the hands of the one asking for help. They will need to examine the underlying blockage to change and adopt a mindset of being genuinely curious about what a solution could be. If your true intention is to find a solution, you'll have an attitude of openness and be ready to problem solve, and your subconscious mind will help you find those solutions. In a loving relationship, your partner will ideally support you and create a safe space to be open to those solutions. If you've recognized these games, feel free to share how you've handled them in the comments. It might help someone else who reads it. I'm also going to add some journaling questions in the descriptions. And if you've liked this video, why not stay on to watch the next one? And I'll see you there.